Good morning, students. Today we will do the sums based on miscellaneous. Miscellaneous means under the different conditions, we have to frame the equation and solve the quadratic. First sum, a hotel bill for a number of people for overnight stay is ₹4,800. If there were four people more, the bill each person had to pay would have reduced by ₹200. Find the number of people staying overnight. So they have given you the hotel bill for number of people. They have not given how many people. So let us assume, let number of people is equal to x. And they have given total bill. Total bill is equal to 4,800. So what will be the bill for each person? So each person bill will become 4,800 divided by x. And then next condition they have given, if there were four people more, if there were four people more, so what will happen now? Number of people will be increased to four, is it not? So x plus four. For the same amount, 4,800, now each person will get 4,800 divided by x plus four. And the difference between the cost, now it is reduced to 200. That means the question is, when you have x person and when it is increased to x plus 4, the cost of each person to pay the bill reduced to 200. So now we see this amount, when the more people is there, our amount will become less. When less people is there, you have to shell out more amount. So we make the equation 4,800 by x minus 4,800 by x plus 4 is equal to, they have given it as ₹200. The extra amount itself is become 200. Now we take the LCM, x into x plus 4 is equal to, on the numerator 4,800 into x plus 4 minus 4,000x is equal to 200. So when we remove the bracket, 4,800x plus 4,800 into 4. 4 zeros are 0, 4 zeros are 0, 4 8s are 32, 4 4s are 16 plus 3, 19,200 minus 4,800x divided by x squared plus 4x is equal to 200. So this will give us 4,000 plus and minus get cancelled. We have 19200 divided by x squared plus 4x is equal to 200. Do cross multiplication, or straight away we can see 200 is common on both the factor. So we divide by 200. 200 will go in 19200 as 96 by x squared plus 4x is equal to 1. We make it as a quadratic, x squared plus 4x minus 96 equal to 0. By splitting the middle term, we get x plus 12 into x minus 8. Because the product of 12 and minus 8 gives you minus 96. And sum of plus 12 and minus 8 gives you plus 4. This gives us x is equal to minus 12 and plus 8. Since we are dealing with number of person, it cannot be in negative. Therefore, number of person, what we assumed, x to be 8. This is our answer. Now, second sum, ₹400 is divided equally among x children. If the number of children were 20 more, then each would have got ₹12 less. Find x. That is, total amount ₹480 is divided equally among x children. So how much each children will get? Each children will get 480 divided by x. For you to understand simply, I have given an example for you. If you have ₹100 totally and there are 5 friends, if you have to divide it equally, that is 100 divided by 5, ₹20. Like that, total amount 480, number of children x, so each children will get 480 by x. Now, this we will make it as first equation. Now, second part, if the number of children were 20 more, that is, this number of children x will become more 20, x plus 20. For the same amount 480, how much they each will get? 480 by x plus 20. Then, question is given, each would have got rupees 12 less. So we will write 480 by x minus 480 by x plus 20 is 12. Now, why we are writing this fraction first? Because when you know, when less children, you get more amount. When you have more children, your share will become less. So, 480 by x, this amount is more than 480 divided by x plus 20. So, the difference is 12. We take LCM, x into x plus 20. You simplify into the quadratic. By taking LCM, 480x, 480 into 20, 9600 minus 480x is equal to 12. You can see this 480 plus and minus gets cancelled. So finally we have 9600 divided by x squared plus 20x is equal to 12. When we do cross multiply, you simplify into that quadratic, 12x squared plus 240x is equal to 9600. Now you can see 12 as a common factor. So we divide by 12 throughout. X squared plus 20x minus 800 is 0, which we can split it into the middle term, x plus 40 and x minus 20. So that you can see sum of these two numbers, plus 40 minus 20 gives you plus 20. Product of plus 40 into minus 20 gives you minus 800. This gives you the value of x to be minus 40 and 20. Since x is number of children we have considered, number of children cannot be negative. So we take number of children is equal to 20. Next. If rupees 6500 was divided equally among certain number of persons, had there been 15 persons more, each would have got rupees 30 less. So like previous sum, total amount is 6500. Number of person we take it as x. So each person gets 6500 by x. Next, if there been 15% more, so the number of person x will increase to x plus 15. For the same amount 6500, we get 6500 divided by x plus 15. Then they will get 30 rupees less. So as I said for you previous sum, less person, more money you get. So 6500 by x is more money minus 6500 by x plus 15 is equal to 30. Now take LCM x into x plus 15, 6500 into x plus 15 minus 6500 into x is equal to 330. When we do cross multiply, we get 3250 divided by x squared plus 15x is 1, which we can rewrite as 3250 is equal to x squared plus 15x. So x squared plus 15x minus 3250 is equal to 0. Split the middle term, x squared. For 15 you can see 65x minus 50x minus 3250 is equal to 0. So we get x plus 65, x minus 50 gives us x is equal to 65 minus 65 or plus 50. We get x is equal to minus 65 or 50. As we say like a previous sum, x is the number of person. So it cannot be in negative. So we take, therefore, x is equal to 50. This is our solution. Next question. Mohan takes 16 days less than Manoj to do a piece of work. If both working together can do it in 15 days, in how many days will Mohan alone complete the work? So we will assume now, the given question is Mohan takes 16 days less than Manoj. So we assume, let Manoj do x number of days. So Manoj does x days. So what will do Mohan takes 16 days less. So x minus 16 days. Together they do 15 days. Together they do 15 days. So now it's all like, you know, more number of days. So normally we have to find it for particular terms, like how much they are doing it, that work, part of the work, complete the work they have given. So Manoj does it for x days. That means the work part is 1 by x. Or you can consider it per day he does it 1 by x. Same way Mohan does it for 1 by x minus 16. So together 15 days. So 1 day work is 1/15, 1 by 15. I'll repeat, you may have a confusion here. Mohan takes 16 days less than Manoj. Mohan takes 16 days less than Manoj to do a piece of work. So we assume that Manoj takes x days and Mohan takes x minus 16 days. Then they both work together for 15 days. So together 15 days. So it's all totally talking about the full work completion. So we consider it per day. So in x days, he does per day 1 by x of a work. In x minus 16 days, he does it part of the work of 1 day is 1 by x minus 16. Total 15 days, he does it for per day 1 by 15. So we put it together like 1 by x per day, both together work for 1 by 15. This when we take LCM, x into x minus 16. So that the numerator will become x minus 16 plus x by 1 by 15. When we simplify, I get 2x minus 16 and do the cross multiplication. 15 is equal to x squared minus 16x. Remove the bracket. 15 2s are 30. 15 16s are minus 240 equal to x squared minus 16x. Put it into the simple quadratic form. X squared minus 30 will go other side. Minus 16 minus 30 minus 46x minus 240 equal to 0. By splitting the middle term, this 46 can be written as minus 40x minus 6x. Can you see minus 40 minus 6 minus 46? This one will go other side plus 240. Product of 40 into 6 is 240 equal to 0. So we can split it into x minus 40 into x minus 6 equal to 0 gives us x is equal to 40 and 6. When we consider now 6 days and x minus 16 will become less than negative term. So we will not consider this. Therefore, Manoj takes 40 days to complete, whereas Mohan takes x minus 16, that is 40 minus 16, which is 24 days. So the sum deals with the per number of days calculation. So whenever the days they have given for the total work, per calculation we should do 1 by x minus 16, and total days is also per day work 1 by 15, and we consider it for per day work and we find the value of x. So the sum is bit difficult, confusing. Please practice more number of times.